Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Summoner's War Sky Arena on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Summoner's War Sky Arena and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Summoner's War Sky Arena. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to start we need to open our favorite web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type anything, because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our own site of Usitility, exactly where we include a in-depth explanation on how you can download and install Summoner's War Sky Arena on PC. We browse down a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we reach the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to enjoy the game Summoner's War Sky Arena on PC. As you can discover here, we access a number of advantages of using that emulator. Then, we will start downloading the Summoner's War Sky Arena by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. We then click on this button. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we have to do is to run the executable file, so we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduce the browser to start to see the installation software significantly better. The installation software is quite simple. It is made up of a couple of choices, install and setup path. I will clarify what setup path really does. We basically simply click on it. And then we see that we display here the path in which the emulator is going to be placed. If we desire to change this directory, we have got to click on the browse option, and we choose another directory and set up the emulator exactly where we wish. I am going to keep it as it is. I click on back, and therefore I simply click on install. Great, the installation commences and it is going to carry on along with the download of these megabytes that are represented on the computer screen. When you download it, it may be slightly more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go at a higher speed or slower, depending on your connection and depending on the speed of the emulator hosting servers. Today they're working extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been started successfully. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar which will advance to the right, then when it gets to the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been started, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it created a couple of software icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the only one we are concerned about. Whenever we are planning to run Summoner's War Sky Arena on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this specific software icon and start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should do the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and which is to enter the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you will notice, the Google Play is launched. In this case we are required to sign in. Right now when we're on this page, we have to perform the next step which is imperative. So we mouse click on Sign In. At this point it says Checking Info. It might once in a while get blocked in Checking Info, additionally it does not move ahead. In that case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours and it may almost certainly be repaired. At this point we are going to type our login name and password. The email has to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For example, you make use of the same email you are using currently in your YouTube account. Thus I am going to type my information and I will return when I have done it. That's all, data typed. Discover Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We will agree to them all by clicking I agree. After that, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can also let it selected and it will produce a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We simply click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To set up the video game, we have to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this app icon marked in green. Currently that we are on the desktop of that emulator for Android, we observe that we have now here the install video game button. We then click on the button. At this point we have the Android game. Let's simply click right here on the install button that I'm displaying now in green color. This will start the software setup. Straight away it should download and install the game. It usually takes quite some time, or it may possibly be very fast. It all depends on our own web connection. It's actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting the following option that I'm showing in green, to be able to launch Summoner's War Sky Arena for the first time. I am by now on the emulator desktop, and as a consequence we're about to click this new Summoner's War Sky Arena icon that was created. That game is started for the very first time. Now there we get it, I'm able to click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the sound level of that emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we do not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the very first one. We then click on this particular software icon that I am actually mentioning in green color. Then the screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In the case that we desire to launch the application in full screen, we click this app icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the game app in 100% screen mode. To leave the full screen functionality, push the F11 key. So we would likely just play in regular display mode. From now, I am going to clarify you the computer keys mapping that is definitely extremely appealing. This strategy we will certainly be ready to use the game more effortlessly. The very first point is to click this application icon. And right now there you will be able to complete the recommended configuration settings. I can leave the default configuration, though if you like to improve it, you can do it without having problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, as an example, in Japanese. So to set it in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. So here throughout many other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We could decide on the language we like, Italian, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is chosen, we would save, the emulator will restart, along with the video game, next time we run it, would as well be in the chosen language. At this time, there is another point that we have to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail indicating that a completely new device has been connected with our Google account. It should ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Absolutely, we must not worry, as the emulator is simulating an Android tablet or smartphone. And then to see which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. Be sure to go here to the model selection. And now we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my video user demo. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that you found it informative. If that's the case, bring it a good like, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer all your remarks, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment field below. You could also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams occasionally, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of those training videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming online videos. Bye.